Hello, welcome to DOL sentence number 45. Let's put it on the screen so everybody can copy it down. Please, let's take a look at this. Number 45, your wallet and house key was on the table in the hall when I left for Marie's office, her mom said. I'll say it again. Your wallet and house key was on the table in the hall when I left for Marie's office, her mom said. Okay, first thing I'm going to ask you, what are the only three words that mom did not say out loud? Or her mom did not say out loud? Of course, her mom said. Everything else she said. So what we do is separate it out with a comma and the rest of the sentence that we have to show that she said it. So we put it in quotation marks. So it goes before your and then after that comma. I understand that the comma is not part of what she said. Technically, it would be a period at the end of what she said. But since I'm adding her mom said to this and making it a longer sentence, I separate out what she said with a comma. And of course, I put a period after her mom said. Okay, let's continue. Let's go right from the top. So, two things I want to do with your, correct? Everybody always tells me to capitalize it and they would be correct. And a lot of students like to tell me to put the apostrophe in there because, of course, whenever you see the RE on your, you always put an apostrophe, correct? Some people would then say, no, Mr. Kenny, no. Let's take a look at it. What two words would I be contracting if I apostrophize it and put RE after you? Of course, I would be saying you are wallet and house key, and that would not work. So let's get rid of the apostrophe and let's get rid of the E. It should say your wallet and house key was on the table in the hall. Let's continue. Wallet, what's wrong with wallet? That looks like wallet. We need it to be another L to make it wallet, good, and house key. Was on the table. There's something sounding wrong with that. Your wallet and house key was on the table. I'm going to ask you, how many things did this person leave on the table? Was it one or two? It's two things. It's a wallet and a house key. How do I put two things into a pronoun? Is it or is it they? Clearly it's they because it's two things. Can I say they was on the table? No, they were on the table. You can say it was on the table, but we're not talking about one thing. So if you got rid of the word wallet and said your house key was on the table, or if you got rid of the words house key, you could say your wallet was on the table, but you cannot say your wallet and house key was on the table because it's two things. So it's your wallet and house key were on the table in the hall. Let's continue. Were on the table in the hall when I left for Marie's office. Clearly, I, singular I's, need to be capitalized anywhere in a sentence, whether it's the beginning, middle, or end. When I left from Marie's office, with Marie's office, I see three things wrong. One, of course, Marie would appreciate it if you capitalized her name. Also, whose office is it? It's Marie's office. And again, her name is Marie, not Marie's. So we put the apostrophe and then we added the S. Excellent. Now, office, that looks like office. How do we fix that? Of course, we put another F in office. And then we have her mom said. Now, at this point, a lot of people would tell me, Mr. Kenny, we always capitalize the word mom, right? And I would say, absolutely not. Because in this case, we're not using it as her name. We're using it as a title, her mom. Just like if you said her teacher said, you don't capitalize teacher. But if you use teacher as a name, hey, teacher, how you doing? Then you would. I have a lot of students in sports who like to call me coach. They say, and even though I'm not a coach, but they do. They get used to calling their coach coach. So they say, hey, coach, how you doing? In that case, they would capitalize C for coach. But if they said, hey, my coach, how you doing? Then they would not. Let's take a look at our sentence and make sure we have it all complete and correct. We have open quotes, your wallet. We got rid of the E, no apostrophe. We fixed wallet by adding another L. Now, remember, we said were because we have two things, one and two, that wallet and the house key act together. Say they were on the table in the hall when we've capitalized our I, left from Marie's office. We capitalized Marie. We put the apostrophe. We fixed office by adding another F. Notice my comma goes inside my quotes. Her mom said with a period at the end. And of course, we did not capitalize mom because we're not using it as her name. Now, moms are important people, but we don't always capitalize those names. Same thing with dad. All right, everybody. Excellent job today. Thank you.